Once upon a time, a long time ago, there was a little boy and girl. Their names were Tim and Rose. Tim was 6 years old and Rose was 5. Tim had black hair and blue eyes. Rose had red hair that hung down to her waist.
Tickle, tickle, tickle.
And green eyes like the sea. They lived with their mummy and daddy in a big log cabin made from trees with a yellow straw roof, and little birds made nests for their eggs in it.
Egg, egg, egg.
Their daddy was a fisherman, and he caught fish in a big lake near the house. Their mummy used to bake lovely fresh bread for them, and in the evenings, by the fire, she would play the trombone for them. They had a fluffy cat called Fluffy Bum and a white puppy dog called Pom Pom, who was very clever and could play the piano with his tail. Every morning, Tim and Rose used to go to Lucy their cow to get some milk for their breakfast. But when they got to the shed where Lucy lived, the door was opened and Lucy was gone. So the children ran to the field where Lucy used to eat the grass and they shouted, "Lucy! Lucy! Where are you?" But there was no sound of Lucy anywhere. "Look, Rose," said Tim, and he pointed to the ground where they could see Lucy's hoof marks in the mud. "Let's follow them and see where she's gone," said Rose. They started to follow the hoof marks. They walked and walked, walked and walked and walked and walked. "Are you getting tired?" said Tim. "Only my legs," said Rose. After a long while, the children came to a big forest with very big trees, some as tall as a church and some as thick as their teacher's legs at school. There was still no sign of Lucy the cow. "It's getting very dark at night time," said Rose. "We better go home or Mummy and Daddy will be worried about us." "No," said Tim. "We must find Lucy first, or she might get lost forever, and we would never have milk on our eggs again." So on they went into the great black forest, but it got so dark they couldn't see where to go. "Oh, are you frightened?" said Rose. Only a little bit," said Tim. "Oh, I feel so sleepy," said Rose. "So do I," said Tim. "You better find someone to sleep soon." Just then, a little voice said,
"Ah, you can come and sleep in my tree."
Oh, the children looked around but couldn't see anyone. "Who said that?" Tim said.
"I did,"
said a little voice. The children looked down and there, standing in a little door at the bottom of a tree, was a teeny-weeny man, as tiny as a matchstick. And he was wearing a buttercup yellow jacket, black trousers with pink spots, and red shiny shoes with gold buckles, and a white pointed hat with a sausage sewn on the front. And with him was a green grasshopper, which the little man had on a dog's lead. "Good heavens! Who are you?" said the children.
"My name is Binklebonk," he said. "I'm a tree goblin. I live in this tree. And this grasshopper is my guard dog. And his name is Silly Sausage."
Then Silly Sausage, the grasshopper dog, went, "Woof!
Meow! Quick! Woof!
Meow!" "What a funny grasshopper," said Tim. "He wanted making a funny noise."
"Yes," said Binklebonk. "That's why I call him Silly Sausage."
"Oh, what's that?" Then they heard strange noises coming from the dark forest.
"Quick! Quick!"
"Good heavens, what was that?" said the children.
"Oh, that's a tin lion," said Binklebonk.
"Well, why did he go squeak?" said Tim.
"Oh, he gets rusty from sleeping in the rain. Oh, you'd better come inside before he comes."
"We're too big to get into that tiny door," said the children.
"Oh, don't worry about that," said Binklebonk. "I can make the tree grow bigger."
"You can't," said the children.
"Ah, yes, I can,"
said Binklebonk.
"Watch me."
He took his finger and he pressed a button on his suit and sang this song.
Tree, tree, 1, 2, 3, please grow very big for me.
And like magic, the tree got bigger and bigger and bigger! Woo! Until the door was big enough for them all to get in.
Follow me,
said Binklebonk, and they all ran inside and locked the door. They followed Binklebonk up a round and round and round staircase, and all the way up there were fireflies and glowworms lighting the darkness. When they got to the top, there were two lovely little children's bedrooms, a white one with red roses for Rose and a lemon one with brown teddy bears for Tim.
Now, keep your windows shut tonight, said Binklebonk, because there are some trouser robbers in the woods.
Trouser robbers, said the children?
Yes, they might rob Tim's trousers, and in the morning poor Tim would have to go without his trousers, just his bare bottom. And a chicken might peck it and make him jump up in the air. Sleep tight, children, said Binklebonk.
Before they went to bed, Binklebonk gave them a real goblin supper. Some nuts, honey, and some real beautiful sweet dandelion tea. And before they went to sleep, the children asked Binklebonk if they had seen Lucy the cow go by the tree.
Well, a black and white cow did go by here this morning.
Rose said, was he wearing a hat?
Yes, he was wearing a straw hat.
Hooray, said the children. That's our Lucy. So the children went to sleep very, very happy because they knew that their milk was still alive. Good night, Tim, said Rose. Good night, Rose, said Tim. During the night, there was a terrible thunderstorm with forked lightning, knife lightning, and spoon lightning. What a funny storm, said Tim. Outside, the rain was pouring onto the trees. Lots of birds' nests got full of water, and all the baby birdies were standing on the side and diving in like a swimming pool. Splash! All the time, the poor old tin lion was saying, oh dear, all this rain is making me rusty. Roar, roar, squeak, squeak, roar, roar, squeak.
Ah!
Next morning, the rain stopped, and the sun came up and said,
come on, time to get up, everybody. I'm going to be very good today. I promise I will shine all day, and I won't hide behind any clouds.
Binklebonk came in and gave the children a cup of fresh grasshopper's milk, some honey and fairy cakes. And when they were dressed, the children said, goodbye, Binklebonk.
Goodbye.
And off they went to find Lucy the cow.
Be very careful in forest, said a little robin redbreast, because there's a wicked witch in there. Her name, Badjelly. She catches little children and turns them into sausage and eat them up. Sometimes she chops children up and make boy-girl soup.
Oh dear, said the children. On and on they went, on and on, until they came to a big river with water rushing over ragged rocks. The children didn't know how to get across, so they sat down to think how to do it.
Oh, oh! Mind where you're sitting, you silly boy, said a voice from underneath Tim's bottom.
It was a little worm.
You big silly. You nearly squashed me flat like a shoelace.
Oh, I'm sorry, Mr. Worm, said Tim. What's your name? The worm came right out of the ground. And he was wearing a long, thin shirt with the drawings of red noses and overdrafts on it.
My name is Mudwiggle, said the worm.
Oh, Mr. Wiggle, did you see a cow wearing a straw hat yesterday?
Yeah, said Mudwiggle. She trod on my tail, so I kung-fued her into the river. Ho, ha, ho, 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 moo, she went.
Oh, you must be very strong, said Tim.
I'm the strongest worm in all the world. Do you know why? Because, I eat mud. Lots of mud.
The worm told the children that Lucy had swum across the river the other day and he'd help her to get a hat out of the water.
Oh, good. Can you help us get across, said Rose. Well, all right, then, said Mudwiggle. I'll just put my swimming costume and overcoat on because the water might be cold.
When he did that, he got into the river.
First, I'll take Rose, right? Get in the river, Rose, and hold my tail. Come on, then, what are you waiting for?
Well, I... which end is your tail, said Rose.
Oh, dear, said Mudwiggle. I'll wear my hat so you know which end is which. So he put on a big red top hat with a piece of cheese on top. That's in case I meet any hungry mice, said Mudwiggle, who's also a Boy Scout. Rose got hold of his tail, and the funny worm dived in and swam across. And then he came back for Tim. But when they were halfway across, a huge giant killer shark saw Tim's legs swimming in the water. So he thought, I'll eat him up.
Look out, said Rose. Shark! Shark!
The shark was just going to bite Tim when wallop, bonk, thud! Mudwiggle hit the horrible shark right on the nose. Boom! Oh, my nose! My poor old shark's nose, said the shark. This is going to ruin the act. So he swam away to the shark's nose hospital. Goodbye, children, said Mudwiggle, and swam away. The sun was shining very hot, and soon the children's clothes were all nice and dry. Then they saw an apple tree, so they plucked two big, juicy red apples.
Oh, my apples, said the tree.
I've never heard an apple tree talk before, said Rhoda.
I'm not an apple tree. I'm really a policeman. But I was turned into an apple tree by the witch called Badjelly. I want to go back to my police station and my whistle and my jam sandwich, he said.
The children said, oh, we are so sorry to hear this. We can't help you because we can't do magic. But if we see another policeman, we'll tell him that you're here and to bring you your whistle and your jam sandwich.
Thank you very much, said the policeman.
The children went on walking until they came to a big mountain. But it had a big white beard on. What a silly mountain, said the children. Why has it got a beard on? A little mouse popped his head out of a hole in the ground.
He's got a beard because he's lost his razor, said the mouse.
Well, we've never heard of a mountain with a beard, said Tim.
He's very old, that's why. And I'm not really a mouse, you see. I've been turned into a mouse by Badjelly, the terrible witch.
Poor little furry mouse, thought Rose. What's your name, said Tim.
My name, said the mouse, is Dingle Mouse.
Well, what were you before the witch turned you into a mouse, said the Rose.
I was a banana, said Dingle Mouse, so be careful. If you see her, you run away from her. Remember her name, Badjelly.
The children said they would remember her name and they would hide if they saw her. Well, we must go and look for Lucy the cow now, said the children.
Wait a minute. Can I come with you, said Dingle Mouse, and be your friend? I got a good singing voice. Just listen to this. Fiddle diddle dee. I'm a little flea. I ran up daddy's trouser legs and I bit him on a knee.
The children liked his singing and said, all right, you can come with us and look for Lucy. Tim picked up Dingle Mouse and put him in his trouser pocket.
I like traveling this way, said the mouse. It's very dark in here, said Dingle Mouse. Where's the light switch?
Rose and Tim laughed. You silly mouse. You don't have a light switch in little boys' trouser pockets.
How did I know that? I never travel by trouser pocket.
So now they all set off to find Lucy. They were climbing up and up a big mountain, and it was getting very cold, and it started to snow.
Oh, I'm freezing cold, said Rose. I'm shivering too, said Tim.
Just then, a voice behind them said,
hello, children. Can I help you?
Tim turned round and saw an old woman dressed in black.
Don't be frightened, she said. I can make you nice and warm in a few seconds. Just get inside this nice sack and you'll be nice and warm.
Oh, thank you, old woman, said Tim. We were nearly freezing to death.
As soon as the children got into the sack, the old woman screamed,
ah! Got you!
She tied the sack up tight.
I'm going to eat you all up because I'm Badjelly, the baddest witch in all the world.
She put the sack on her back, jumped onto a broomstick and flew up
into the sky. Someone please help us, shouted Tim.
No one could hear him because they were very high in the sky.
The witch took the children to her castle on top of the mountain. It was made of iron.
Ow, my head!
And only the witch had the key to get in. At the gate was a huge, horrible monster. His body was red and sticky. It had giant eyes as big as windows and sharp yellow teeth like needles. And its tongue was made of fire, and all its spit turned to steam. It went. When Badjelly ever ate children, she used to put them on the monster's fire tongue to cook them. The witch opened the door. Inside was her servant, a giant called Dulboot. He was as big as a house. He had purple hair and 10 eyes all round his head, so he could see if he had pimples on his back. Badjelly told the giant to take the sack with the children in it.
Put them into a dark room right at the top of the prison. And don't let them out of the sack. I'm going to eat them when the sun comes up in the morning with peanut butter.
All right, said the giant.
He carried the sack up thousands of steps. He opened a door and he threw the sack with the children in on the cold stone floor and locked the door. Poor Tim and Rose were crying. Then out of Tim's pocket popped Dingle Mouse.
Don't cry! Don't cry, children. I got sharp teeth. Watch this.
And he started to nibble and nibble, and he made a hole big enough for them to get out of the sack. Poor Rose was crying.
We'll never see our mother or daddy again. Tomorrow the witch will eat us all up with peanut butter.
The sun was going down, and the room was getting very dark. Dingle Mouse suddenly cried,
I got an idea. You got an idea? I got an idea. I know a big, strong eagle called Jimmy's my friend, and he owes me money. I'll go and try and get him.
Dingle Mouse jumped up on the ledge, and climbed the ivy on the outside of the tower all the way down to the ground.
Please hurry! Hurry! The witch is going to kill us in the morning, said the children.
So Dingle Mouse ran as fast as he could. He ran so fast, his tail caught fire, and he had to sit in a bucket of cold water to put it out.
Oh, that's...
Oh, dear, it was so sad. Back at the children's home, their mummy was crying.
Oh, my poor children, where are they?
The daddy said, I look everywhere, dear. I think some terrible animal in the forest must have eaten them.
Mother cried.
I'll never be able to play the trombone to them again, she said.
By now, Dingle Mouse had reached the tree where Jim the giant eagle was asleep.
An eagle?
Jim! Jim, wake up! Jim, wake up! Jim, yep-a-dub-a-doo!
Jim was a beautiful eagle with brown feathers on his body, white feathers on his head, and a big yellow beak and blue eyes, and he was nearly as strong as God.
Hurry up, Jim! The witch is gonna eat the children when the sun comes up with peanut butter!
So Jim the eagle quickly took off his pajamas. Dingle Mouse jumped on Jim's back, and away they flew!
Faster, Jim, faster! The sun will soon be coming up! Hurry, hurry, hurry!
Back in the prison room, the children were looking out the window.
Can you see anyone coming to save us, Tim? Said Rose. No, no, I can't, said Tim. Oh, look, said Rose. The sun is starting to come up. Listen. I can hear the witch coming up the stairs.
I'm coming to get you,
screamed the witch. They could see her through the keyhole, and she had a big, sharp knife.
But wait. Look, said Rose, out the window. It's Jim the Eagle. Jim the Eagle is coming.
The witch was starting to open the door. Now Jim the Eagle flew up to the window. Quick, children, get on my back, hurry. But the witch was opening the door. The children were getting on Jim's back.
Stop them,
screamed the witch.
Stop them.
But the children were on the mighty eagle's back. And away they flew, away from the terrible witch. And she was so angry, she screamed,
Stinky Poo! Stinky Poo! Knickers, knickers, knickers!
Then she jumped on her fastest broomstick and started to chase after the children. and she took a magic powder to throw on the children and turn them into Chinaman's legs. Jim the Eagle flew up and up, and he hid inside a cloud. And the witch flew round and round. Round and round the cloud she flew, waiting for Jim and the children to come out. Just then God came along, and when he saw what the wicked witch was going to do to Tim and Rose, he told the witch, "Go away."
"No, I won't! I won't!"
said the witch, and tried to scratch God's eyes out. So God pointed his finger at the witch and... The witch had burst like a bomb and disappeared in smoke, and her broomstick turned into a sky snake that flew up to the moon. When Jim the Eagle saw that Badjelly was dead, he flew the children back to the witch's castle to look for Lucy. "Lucy! Lucy!" "There she is," said Rose. And there, chained to the wall, was poor Lucy. Quickly, Jim flew down next to her, and she was so pleased to see the children, she licked them on their faces. And she went, "Moo! Oh, moo!" Jim the Eagle broke her chain with his beak. But then the back door of the castle opened, and out came Dulboot, the giant.
"Get away from that cow. It belongs to me. She's my dinner," he said.
And he drew out his sword, and he tried to chop the children's heads off. But Jim grabbed the giant by his hair. Ooh! While Dingle Mouse jumped on the giant, nibbled his belt, and down came the giant's trousers.
"Oh, help," said the giant. "I'm showing my bare bottom."
And he ran away to Bare Bottom Land. "Now we're all safe," said Tim. "Hooray," said everybody. "Yes, thanks to Dingle Mouse and Jim," said Rose, and she gave them both a beautiful big kiss. Then Jim got the children and Dingle Mouse on his back. He grabbed Lucy's horns in his strong claws, and he flew up, up, and flew them all the way back to their home. But when their mummy and daddy saw them fly down on the back of a giant eagle with Lucy hanging underneath, they got frightened and they ran inside the house and hid. "Don't be frightened, mummy and daddy," said Tim and Rose. "He's only an eagle." "Oh, no, no, we're frightened. We're frightened to come out of that giant eagle. He'll kill us." "No, no, he won't," said Rose and Tim. "He's friendly. He's kind. He'll help you." "All right, then, if you say so." Down they flew and landed. "Don't be frightened, Mummy and Daddy. Jim is a kind eagle and he saved our lives," said Tim and Rose as they landed. And up popped Dingle Mouse.
"Oh, so did I help save their lives too," he said.
So Mummy and Daddy came out with a big bag of jelly babies and cream cakes, and they gave them to Jim and Dingle Mouse, and they all played Ring of Rosies, and then they blindfolded Lucy and played Blind Cow's Buff, and they lived happily ever after. Good night, children.